Cool, awesome. Cool to be the last person to speak. Really humbled and privileged to be speaking in and amongst really cool community builders, following your work. It's been really awesome. So cool to be speaking to you guys tonight. So today I want to talk about the Random Acts of Kindness group that Collart was talking about and what Free Hugs taught me about community building. But first I'd like to say this is me right there. I'm sort of the guy freaking out over there. I run an organization called the Young Innovators Collective, and it's all about thinking about how we might creatively empower young people. And there's a good group of us, and this is a photo from a project that we did called Changemakers Tribes, and it's a network of changemakers across New Zealand, and this was one of our gatherings. We had 50 young people in a circle sharing stories, ideas, projects. It was pretty cool. But today, I want to talk about the Random Acts of Kindness group, hashtag happy, and take you on a bit of a journey of how it started, how it became a thing, where it is now, and some of the trials and tribulations of building a community. So where did the inspiration come from? There were two pieces, one that I'll talk about now, one bit later. The first one was this meetup group, Be Kind Auckland. About 3 years ago, I was surfing meetup.com, taking a look at the various different groups. I would have been just finishing high school and felt like I needed to get out in the community and start different things and try different things. And I found this Random Acts of Kindness group called Be Kind Auckland. And I looked at it and I sort of thought, it kind of looks like a cosmetic brand. It didn't really feel like a Random Acts of Kindness group. And I went in there and there was about 40 members in there. And if you know Meetup, it's not necessarily the largest group. And about a week later, I woke up to this email, and it was from Grace, the organizer, and she was saying, I'm in a bit of a funny situation, but I have a question for you. I'm relocating to Melbourne, and I'd like desperately to find someone to take Be Kind Auckland over. And in that moment, I sort of thought about it, and I thought, well, what can I do? And the first thing that I thought was, well, how do we change that branding logo? How do we change it from not being a cosmetic brand to something a little bit more interesting, a little bit more representative of the type of work and the type of stuff that we really wanted to do? The hashtag was at the time a cool thing. Now it's kind of awkward, but hashtag happy was what we went with. And it was really cool. Meetup does this thing when you start up a group. In the first 3 days, nothing happens, but on the third day, it launches it out to its newsletter, and it launches out to hundreds of thousands of people. And we had a couple hundred people in the first week, which was really cool. And when we did that, we had these 200 people. I was pretty excited. I had just finished high school. I was sort of going, right, okay, 200 people, Random Acts of Kindness, what can we do? And we had this thing called the Amazing Race. September 1st was Random Acts of Kindness Day, 2014. And I'd spent a shitload of money trying to get a bunch of my high school friends to come to this event. And I created these flyers that pretty much had 10 challenges on it that people had to do on the day. And some of the 10 challenges are there, but this was a draft one, but things like pay a stranger a compliment or put a note inside a library book. And the idea went really well. On Facebook, it had about 200 people going, which is not when Facebook had the interested thing, so I totally believe that 200 people were gonna come. Mistake. I had, you know, speakers hired out, that was a couple hundred bucks. I had like all these flyers printed out, that was a couple hundred bucks. And I put a bunch of money into it, all the stuff that I'd sort of saved up in high school. And then I learned a valuable lesson about community, is that Facebook tends to lie when it comes to events. But also, you can never really tell what the weather's like. What 200 people said they're going on Facebook, and then it rains the next day, only 30 people showed up, which was kind of a shame, but also still pretty awesome, having 30 people come for the Amazing Race. And to give you an example of what was one of the things that made that day awesome, was one of the challenges was walk an old lady across the street. But because it was raining, there wasn't many old ladies walking across the street. I think there was one old lady and like she got walked across the street by four different teams, so it's kind of funny. We did other things. We did this thing called International Happiness Day. We had this frame, and it brought together a bunch of people, you know, people, old people, young people, people who are walking around Aotea Square, people working at Aotea Square, the Hare Krishna group, which was really cool. And it was really awesome. You know, I mean, at that point, all I had was this idea of bringing people together around doing stuff awesome around happiness. And it came into different types of forms. And it was really just crazy random ideas that took a little while to set up. But after they were made happen and put out into the public, people really engaged with it. So the crazy ideas sort of worked in that initial stage. And then came Free Hugs, and Free Hugs was a real interesting one because that one sort of isolated the, or sort of divided the community. There were a couple of the people who were like right as the early adopters going, yes, we want to hug people, we want to like share the love, spread the love, hippie love, all that type of stuff. And those are the people who came to the event. So you can see the seven people who turned up. and they're awesome. And Free Hugs was really cool. It was a really special, amazing thing when these seven people put themselves out there into the community, especially the woman, when they're sort of there and vulnerable and putting themselves out there and trusting strangers, it can become quite a powerful thing when people match you and trust that and sort of honor that connection and vulnerability. Other times there were just two people, and this is me and Carrie, and Carrie was a long time happy, hashtag happy volunteer. And this event was particularly special because the thing about Free Hugs, and when we do it down at Brit Amart, we tend to see the people who are coming from their 9-to-5 jobs, just from the ANZ buildings or the various ones around Brit Amart. And there was one woman who came out of there, and you could tell that that day was not going well for her. She seemed like she hadn't been seen by anyone. She hadn't been acknowledged by anyone. And to have Carrie be there standing open arm with a free hug sign saying, free hug? She was overwhelmed. She couldn't believe it. And she bawled her eyes out and she was telling us a story of how she doesn't feel acknowledged in the workplace. And to have a stranger say hello and give her a hug meant the world to her. And so sometimes free hugs can remind us of our humanity in that way. Though in that photo, you can kind of tell that I'm kind of a little bit tired, and I was running this thing, and it had been 2.5 years in, and it wasn't making any money or anything, and at this time, I was trying to figure out the whole uni thing and life thing and work thing and all that stuff. So I tried these really cringe online stuff. I did this like newsletter thing, and I sent people challenges. I got really creative. I told people to plant stuff. Like, that didn't go down well, and I thought that woman with the bread was funny, but it just wasn't. It was awkward. And then I realized that, you know, I had all these people in this community group. Why didn't I ask them? Why didn't I tell them? You know, why can't you contribute? Start an event or try something out yourself. And that's when I started a Facebook group, and I'm running out of time, so I'm just going to continue quickly through this. But I started a Facebook group, had some polls, got some people around us, and asked what they wanted. And it was pretty powerful. Like, all of a sudden, when I started thinking about community with that contribution lens, how do I empower people within our community to contribute and start events? Things started changing. We had our last Free Hugs event, which is only a few weeks ago, to have 273 people going to our Free Hugs event rather than just two only a couple years ago, and then 1,200 people interested, which was really awesome. And then we got invited to Splore, which was really cool, to do Free Hugs. They gave us five free tickets to do Free Hugs, which was really awesome as well. So three quick lessons. One, engage with a compelling story. The branding with the whole cosmetics brand thing, change the look, make it something that people understand right from the get-go so they understand what they're getting into, what they want to be about and belong to. And the second thing, inspire participation by creating stuff. Put stuff out there. Say that you're trying something different. Be transparent about the requests you're making for people to be a part of. And then the last thing, which is I've learned the hard way, empower to contribute. Get your champions who are most active in your community and ask them what they want. Create stuff. Call them out and say, you're active. Make something happen. So quick story and leaving message. The quick story is why this all began and why this all started. The second piece of inspiration I got from right at the beginning. And that was a Facebook post I saw where there was a guy and a girl in a car. It's a little story. A guy and a girl in a car. And the girl's looking at the guy as he sort of smiles and waves at anyone who walks by them. They're in the car, and someone walks past the crosswalk, and he's looking at them and waving and smiling and saying hello. And they do that as they walk through the streets and stuff. And so one day, the girl asks the guy, why do you do that? Why do you take a moment to always do that? And he had said that one of his friends got into a place where he decided that the best thing for him to do was to take his own life. And on the way, walking towards a bridge to leap off it, he then told that friend later on that if only one person had looked at them, if only one person acknowledged them before that he had decided to take his own life, then he may or may not have done it. He might not have done it. And that sort of little message that really struck me right at the beginning 3 years ago, I thought, if only we can acknowledge every single one of us walking down the street, we never know who's coming out of those buildings who aren't being recognized for what they do, or feel like they don't matter, or feel like they don't belong. You know, I think the trust, the acknowledgement of our humanity, what connects us, is what community is all about. And so I want to leave with that message. Really appreciate your attention. Thank you so much.
Thank you, my friend.